Sorry, car. Dale, you missed the trash can.
Meh.
Dale, you're gonna pick up that can, right?
Maybe I'll pick it up, maybe I won't. We call that suspense.
So are you gonna pick up that can, Dale?
I have a to-do list a mile long, but when I get done with everything on that list, I can't lie to you, Bill. I'm not gonna do it.
Open that door, Dale.
What do you want?
I want you to pick up the can.
Why me? You're closer, geez.
I swear, it's like you don't have any respect for me.
Of course I don't. Look at you.
I'm tired of being ignored. You're picking that can up right now.
Yeah.
Kind of difficult to,
Pick it up.
I don't want to.
Do it.
Grandma and Dotrieve really going at it. The chain-smoking anorexic versus the heart attack waiting to happen. Who will die first? Let's watch.
I don't know why you're so worried about that can, Bill. If it's anything like your ex-wife, it'll come to its senses and walk away. Forever.
You know what? I haven't liked you for years.
Hold on, Bill.
Dale, the only reason I ever hung out with you was because of Boomhauer and Hank.
Oh, really? Then how come just last week you said you were my best friend?
I pretended you were Hank when I said it!
Okay, that's enough, you two.
You're dead to me, Bill Dotrieve!
Good! I'd rather be dead than be your friend anyway!
Boycott Dale Gribble! He is an exterminator of bugs and friendship! Do not let him into your house or your hearts!
This fight seems to be getting serious. Looks like I'm gonna have to do something to end this. I'm gonna go grab a case of Alamo Gold and sit him down until this thing is figured out.
I think it's too late for that. This has gone beyond a fight and has officially become a dude-vorce.
A what?
A dude-vorce is what happens when male friends break up. Parade magazine did a whole half page on it.
It's true. I heard that one in two male friendships now ends in dude-vorce. It's so sad when dudes grow apart.
Tell him I want my kiddie pool and my leaf blower.
Okay, next issue. Gribble wants a kiddie pool and his leaf blower back, as well as the alley on Saturdays.
No sale! We already gave you the all-in-high football ticket and the alley every other Sunday.
What the heck is going on here?
Hank, when it comes to a breakup, there are no winners, only losers. Two losers.
Can you guys just put it on hold for a second? I have some stuff I have to give you from my dad. Cotton brought that fork back from Germany. I'm pretty sure he killed somebody with it.
It's beautiful. I love getting gifts, Hank. I'm pretty sure Dale doesn't know that, though, since he hasn't gotten me anything for my birthday for the last 14 years. That's right, I counted.
What can you possibly give the man who has nothing?
Look, I could really use both of your help with my dad's estate, so just punch each other or grill a steak and get this ridiculous fight over with.
Meat won't solve this, Hank.
Not this time. So either pick a side or get lost.
Now, where were we?
Gribble's gonna need that fork.
No way!
It'll go well with his knife.
Give him fork, Dotrieve.
I don't know, Hank. General Patton's toilet would definitely be in my top three places where I'd like to get flushed. Right behind the one Elvis died on, and yours.
I want my skeleton to be dismantled and sent in a box to Singapore to be remantled.
Dang it, Dale. If you're gonna participate in the discussion, you have to be here in person.
No can do. Not as long as what's his fat is there.
According to our agreement, I have the alley from 3 to 5 p.m. Con said it's within my legal right to pull his batteries out at any time. Hey!
Relax, Bill.
So when do you and I and not Bill leave, Hank? I've got my flushing arm ready.
What? Why does Dale get to go flush the colonel? I hate Dale. We all hate Dale.
Dang it, I've had enough of this. Neither of you are going. Boomhauer, we leave tonight. Now, yo, man.